Even for billionaires, some purchases are splurges. From skyscraper houses to priceless works of art, the world's elite buy ridiculously expensive things to fuel their passions, showcase their wealth, or spend the money just because they can. Whether it's the most expensive thing they own or just the most exotic, the splurges of the world's wealthiest are always interesting. Here are the craziest things owned by the richest people in the world. Before we start, do not forget to subscribe down below and click the bell button so you'll get notified whenever we post a new video. Clive Palmer's Titanic. An average cost of $425 million to $567 million. Some rich people settle for luxury yachts, but for Australian businessman and politician Clive Palmer, only the most famous ship in the history will do. The Titanic, however, has been at the bottom of the Atlantic Oceans since it sunk in 1912. Not easily swayed, Palmer commissioned Titanic II, a nearly exact replica of the doomed 9-deck White Star Line ship, right down to the grand staircase feature in the 1997 movie, but updated for modern travel. Also important to note, Titanic II has enough lifeboats for everyone on board. Top 9. Elon Musk's car submarine, with an estimated cost of roughly $1 million. Tech billionaire Elon Musk is the mind behind the Hyperloop tunnel, so it stands to reason that his own method of personal transportation might be less than ordinary. In 2013, the Tesla and SpaceX founder became the proud owner of the Lotus Spirit submarine car from James Bond glory in The Spy Who Loved Me. Top 8. Jocelyn Wildenstein's plastic surgery, with an estimated cost of $4 million. In her prime, Swiss socialite Jocelyn Wildenstein hunted with a Saudi arms dealer, dated a European filmmaker. Jocelyn is now in her 70s, and her bizarre and self-inflicted appearance is an often cited cautionary tale about excessive and obsessive plastic surgery. According to the Mirror, Wildenstein spent $4 million throughout the course of her decades-long physical transformation. Top 7. Prince Hans Adam II's fancy furniture, with an estimated cost of $36 million. In 2004, Prince Hans of the tiny nation Liechtenstein dropped $36 million in a piece of furniture that you probably won't find in IKEA. Dating to the 18th century, the Florentine ebony piece known as the Bedminton Cabinet is adorned with precious stones like lapis lazuli, agate, and amethyst quartz. When the prince bought the cabinet chest, the purchase broke its own record. The Bedminton Cabinet was already the world's priciest piece of furniture after selling for $16.59 million in 1990. Top 6. The Sultan of Brunei's car collection, with an estimated cost of $5 billion. It's good to be a sultan. Need proof? Just take a look at the collection of cars owned by the Sultan of Brunei, who rules a country smaller than the state of Delaware. His legendary fleet contains between 5,000 and 7,000 of the world's rarest, finest, best-performing, and most expensive cars, which top speed values are combined $5 billion, at least. Among the finest gems are 21 Lamborghinis, 452 Ferraris, 604 Rolls-Royce, including the Star of India, a $14 million Rolls convertible that has the distinction of being the world's most expensive car. Top 5. Bill Gates' Scientific Scribbles by Leonardo da Vinci, with an estimated cost of $30 million. Bill Gates and Leonardo da Vinci have a lot in common. They're both a math geniuses who also change history. It's only fitting then that the Microsoft founder would be interested in the musings of the original Renaissance man. In 1994, Gates spent $30.8 million to own the Codex Leicester, a 72-page manuscript that Da Vinci compiled in the early 16th century, complete with a master polymath's diagram, writing, sketches, and ideas for future inventions. Top 4. Prince Al-Walid bin Talal's Airbus A380 or the Flying Palace, with an average cost of $500 million. Membership in the Saudi royal family's inner circle certainly has its perks. Prince Al-Walid bin Talal, for example, already owned a $220 million Boeing 747, but in his world, that's small potatoes. In 2007, he paid $319 million for an A380 double-decker super jumbo jet, the world's largest passenger aircraft. He ordered upgrades, including space for his horses and two Rolls-Royce cars, that sent the sticker price soaring past $500 million. Before it was even ready, however, he sold his newest toy to an undisclosed buyer. Top 3. Larry Ellison's Hawaiian Island with an average cost of $300 million. For the richest of the rich, even the grandest mansion simply won't do. For Oracle founder Larry Ellison, home is the Hawaiian island of Lanai, which he picked up in 2012 for a cool $300 million, according to CNBC. His tropical paradise includes 90,000 acres, includes two Four Seasons resorts, and a town with a population of 3,200. Considering a stay in one of those resorts, you will certainly vacation in luxury, but it will cost you $21,000 a night. Top 2. Roman Abramovich superyacht with an estimated cost of $1.2 billion. It's no secret that yachts are key weapons in the battle for one-upsmanship among the world's elite. But if boats are a competition, billionaire Russian oligarch Roman Abramovich wins, hands down. Among his toys are Boeing 767, an ice boat, and the legendary Chelsea Football Club. The grandest possession of them all, however, is his claim to the world's largest and most expensive yacht, the Eclipse. Launched in 2010, the Eclipse boasts 6,000 square feet of living space across 11 staterooms and suites. Need to abandon ship quickly? No sweat. The boat's three-person submarine can dive to 160 feet. Top 1. Steve Cohen's 14-foot preserved shark with an estimated cost of $8 million to $12 million. Plenty of rich people have impressive fish tanks, but that's child play compared to laying claim to your own pickled shark. In 2004, billionaire hedge fund manager Steve Cohen bought what just might be the world's most unique piece of contemporary art, a 14-foot tiger shark preserved a combination of alcohol and formaldehyde. Originally purchased for $93,000 in 1992 by art mogul Charles Saatchi, Cohen bought the piece, the physical impossibility of death in the mind of someone living. More than a decade later, for an undisclosed amount, which New York Magazine reported to be between $8 million to $12 million. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you learned a thing or two. Do not forget to subscribe down below and click the bell button so you'll get notified whenever we post a new video. That's it for today's video. Goodbye!